إن الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. وبعد، يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. وبعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدى هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. أما بعد، يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى: إن عدة الشهور عند الله 12 شهرا في كتاب الله يوم خلق السماوات والأرض، منها أربعة حرم، ذلك الدين القيم، فلا تظلموا فيهن أنفسكم، وقاتلوا المشركين كافة كما يقاتلونكم كافة. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ عِدَّةَ الشُّهُورِ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ 12 شَهْرًا فِي كِتَابِ اللَّهِ يَوْمَ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضِ. Surely the number of months in the decree of Allah, in the book of Allah, is 12. There's 12 months in a year. Since Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the heavens and the earth, that is the order which has been there. 12 months in a year. منها أربعة حرم. From those 12, we have four sacred months. Four sacred months. And we are in one of those four sacred months. This is Dhul Hijjah. It's one of the four sacred months. And the month which is coming very shortly, Muharram, it is one of the sacred months also. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَلَا تَظْلِمُوا فِيهِنَّ أَنفُسَكُمْ. So do not oppress yourselves in these 4 months. These 4 months are more sacred than all other months. We have to be more God-fearing. We have to be more conscious in these 4 months. In a number of days, we are going to enter into a new Islamic year, Amun Jadid. In fact, this is the last week of this year. In fact, this is the last Jum'ah of this year. 1434. This is the last week, the last Jum'ah. We are finishing a year, we are going to a new year. Muharram shall start maybe Monday or Tuesday. Bi-idhnillah. One of the four sacred months, like we've just said. It is a time for each of us to contemplate and to sit and to remember what we have put forth in these last 12 months. It is a time for each of us to see and to account himself. As Umar ibn Khattab and Abu Bakr radhiyallahu anhu, they used to say, حاسبوا أنفسكم قبل أن تحاسبوا. You should account yourself before the day you'll be accounted by Allah. Because that is one of the best way to keep yourself in check. It is one of the best way for you to be a good Muslim. Account yourself. Imagine you are the one who's judging yourself. Ask yourself, how much have I done in this year? Ramadan came and went. The 10 days of Dhul Hijjah, they started and they went. Now we are finishing Dhul Hijjah and a new year is going to start. What have we done? And what are we preparing to do? This is something you have to think of, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he praised himself in his book that one of the things he does, one of his ayat, min ayatihi annahu yuqallibu al-layl wal-nahar wa yukawwiru al-nahar ala al-layl wal-nahar ala al-layl. From his ayat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he praised himself, he changes the day into night and the night into day. And in fact, he mentioned, only those who are really God-fearing, only those who are smart, they are the ones who pay attention to this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاخْتِلَافِ اللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ لَآيَاتٍ لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ. Allah says, surely in the creation of the heaven and the earth, the way these two creations have been created, and surely in the changing of the day and the night, لآيات, you have signs. You have signs, but not for everyone. لأولي الألباب, for those who are smart, for those who are intelligent enough to know that this is something to think of. In fact, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, this ayah, whoever does not think over it, then there's no good in him. Or he said, I fear for him, he'll be punished. إِنَّ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ, surely in the creation of the day and the night, surely in the creation of the heavens and the earth, وَاخْتِلَافِ اللَّيْلُ وَالنَّهَارِ, and the changing of day and night, meaning the going of the days, the passing of the months, the passing of the years, لَآيَاتٍ لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ, in that is signs for those who have intellects. Who are they? And how do you benefit? How do you benefit? Wallahi, it only means one thing. It only means that me and you, we're just getting closer to our graves. It only means that me and you, we're only getting close to meeting Malakul Maut, the angel of death. It only means one thing. It means my end and your end is coming to a close. Allah described them, those who are smart, intelligent. He says, الَّذِينَ يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهَ قِيَامًا وَقُعُودًا وَعَلَىٰ جُنُوبِهِمْ. They are the ones who remember and mention Allah in all states. When they are sitting, when they are standing and walking, when they are lying down, they are always in the remembrance of Allah. Those are the smart ones. Not the one who has more PhD of us. Not the one who has the most degrees. لا والله. Not in front of Allah. The clever and the smart one is the one who thinks over the creation of the heavens and the earth and the interchanging of days and nights. They are the ones who remember and mention Allah wherever state they are in, sitting or walking or standing or they're laying down. وَيَتَفَكَّرُونَ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Allah says, in the second quality of these people, they think over the creation of the heavens and the earth. When you look how the heaven has been created, whatever is in it, and the earth and whatever is in it, you know the greatness of the one who created this great creation. Every week, the scientists, they continue to find a new species in the oceans. Until now, humankind, we only know 10% of what is in the ocean. That tells you how great the one who created this is. They think over the creation of the heavens and the earth. The one who created this sun, which me and you cannot look at the sun for more than 2 minutes. You go blind. Why do we forget that? How long can you hold your breath as a human being? 10, 15 minutes maybe, can you do that? Nobody can do that. Look how weak you are and look how great the one who created that is. You think over the creation of the heavens and the earth. When they think over these things, it only leads them to one thing. They say, رَبَّنَا مَا خَلَقْتَ هَذَا بَاطِلًا. Oh, our Lord, you did not create all of this in vainness, with nothing, because of nothing. No. It did not just start up from a big bang and that's it, and it's going to die. No. Allah created the heavens and the earth for a purpose. And that is for human beings to live, and then there'll be judgment. Subhanak, you are glorified. You did not create this from vainness. No, there's a purpose behind it. Faqina adhab an-nar, so save us from the hellfire. This is what these people say. the smart ones, the intelligent ones. When you think of Allah's creation and you see the changing of the days and the night, you know that you're growing old, you're going closer to your grave. It only should lead you as a Muslim to have more fear of Allah, to have fear of that burning punishment of the hellfire, waliyadhan billah. That is what they say, رَفَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ, save us from the hellfire. رَبَّنَا إِنَّكَ مَنْ تُدْخِلِ النَّارَ فَقَدْ أَخْزَيْتَ. O Allah, because the one you will make to enter the hellfire, you have humiliated him. وَمَا لِلظَّالِمِينَ مِنْ أَنصَارِ, and those who are the oppressors will go to the hellfire, they won't have any helper. ربنا إننا سمعنا مناديا ينادي للإيمان أن آمنوا بربكم فآمنا. Oh our Lord, Ya Allah, this is what these people, they say, the smart ones. We have heard the call of the caller who said to us, believe in your Lord, and we have believed. فاغفر لنا ذنوبنا, so Allah forgive our sins. وكفر عنا سيئاتنا, and expiate our bad deeds. وَتَوَفَّنَا مَعَ الْأَبْرَارِ, and make us die among those who are your good slaves. These are the smart ones. Those who sit and contemplate. They don't just leave, because we don't just leave. We leave for a purpose. There's a purpose of life. And all of us know it is to worship Allah. So the changing of the days and the night is something we should think of. As every night passes, it means it's one less night for me and you. Every day which passes means it's one less day for me and you to do good deeds and to ask Allah to save us from the hellfire. فَاسْتَجَابَ لَهُمْ رَبُّهُمْ أَنِّي لَا أُضِيعُ عَمَلَ عَامِلٍ مِّنْكُمْ مِّنْ ذَكَرٍ أَوْ أُنثَى بَعْضُكُمْ مِّنْ بَعْضٍ. So these people who thought and they contemplate and they take heed of the changing of the days of the night, these people who remember Allah in every situation and every place and every time, these people who ask Allah to save them from the hellfire, these people who act goodness, Allah says, Allah, he replied and responded and accepted their du'as and their actions. I will not let your actions go in vain, Allah says to them. أَنِّي لَا أُضِيعُ عَمَلَ عَامِلٍ مِّنْكُمْ مِّنْ ذَكَرٍ أَوْ أُنثَى, male or female, there's no discrimination. It is something to think about, ya ikhwan. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says to us, كُنْ فِي الدُّنْيَا كَأَنَّكَ غَرِيبٌ وَعَابِرِ السَّبِيلِ, live in this world as if you are a stranger. As if you are a stranger. Someone in a strange land. Oh, you're just a passerby. You are on transit. You're just on transit. That's how you're supposed to live in this world. And that's why Allah has nights and days for us to remember. My time is going. The years are flying by. It's for us to remember. I'm just getting close to the meeting with my Lord. What have I prepared? That is why when one of the Ansar, he came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and said to him, Ya Rasulallah, Ayyun nas akyas, which of the people is the most smart? Who amongst the people is the most smart? فَقَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, أَكْثَرُهُمْ ذِكْرًا لِلْمَوْتِ وَأَشَدُّهُمْ لِمَا بَعْدَهُ إِسْتِعْدَادًا أُولَئِكَ هُمُ الْأَكْيَسُ أُولَئِكَ هُمُ الْأَكْيَسُ. The most smart of all people and the most intelligent. This is what this Sahaba is asking the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, my and your Prophet. Who is the most smart of all people? And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says to him, the one who remembers death more frequently and the one who prepares for what is coming after death. That is the smart one, that is the smart one. Because wallahi, that house we want to build, me and you, and that investment you want to make, and all those prospects you have for the future, you have no guarantee. But there is one guarantee. كُلُّ نَفْسٍ ذَائِقَةُ الْمَوْتِ, every soul shall taste death. That is a guarantee. So the smart one is the one who prepares for what is coming. أولئك هم الأكيس، أولئك هم الأكيس. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم والبر الكريم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. بعد، اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد، وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد، كما صليت باركت على إبراهيم وآل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. A new year is going to start. And this is only a reminder again for us to prepare ourselves for death and what is coming after death. We don't have any special celebrations for a new year. We don't celebrate new years in Islam. And the month of Muharram, it is one of the sacred months, like we said. And one day is more special in that month. That is the day of Ashura. Is a day which we fast because the Prophet ﷺ, he fasted, because it is the day Allah saved Musa alayhi salatu wasalam and Banu Israel from Fir'aun. That is the reason we fast, no more, no less. We don't have any crazy superstitious beliefs that nobody should get married in Muharram. There's nothing like that. There's nothing like that Islamic. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to us, Ya ikhwan, وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ وَعِدَّةٍ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. Hasten, rush to the forgiveness of your Lord and a Jannah which is as wide as the heavens and the earth. It has been prepared for those who fear their Lord. Who are these people? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, الذين ينفقون في السراء والضراء. They are the ones who give in charity during times of happiness, when things are easy, life is good, and when even life is constricted, they just give. Why? Because they are preparing for tomorrow, death. والكاظمين الغيظ. They are the people whom, when people anger them, they control their anger. والعافين عن الناس. And more than that, they forgive those people who wronged them. Then Allah continues to describe them in the next ayah. وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا فَعَلُوا فَاحِشَةً أَوْ ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ ذَكَرُوا اللَّهَ فَاسْتَغْفَرُوا لِذُنُوبِهِمْ وَمَنْ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ إِلَّا اللَّهَ وَلَمْ يُصِرُّوا عَلَى مَا فَعَلُوا وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ. And those whom, when they commit a sin, they wrong themselves, they return back to Allah, they remember Allah, because they see the days and the night. They know, why am I sinning and my time is going? Why am I sinning when another month has passed? Why am I continuing sinning when a year is passing? Why haven't I started praying when my days are going? Why don't I help my own relatives, my mom and my children and my good brothers and sisters when my time is going? They remember. فَاسْتَغْفَرُوا اللَّهُ. So they ask Allah's forgiveness. And Allah forgives them if they are sincere. A new year is starting. It is a time for us to be thankful. Nobody bothered you. You came to pray Jum'ah here. Alhamdulillah. Our brothers in Sham, they are being bombarded and being killed, massacred every day and night. They know the importance of every day and every night, because every hour counts. But me and you, we are heedless. Why? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, though, I personally have a good feeling that a Nasr, the victory from Allah, is close for our brothers in Sham. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Tuba li Sham, Tuba li Sham, Tuba li Sham. Good news, give good news for Sham, good news, good news. They asked, why, Ya Rasulullah? He said, Fa inna malaikatur Rahman wadi'u ajnihataha ala Sham. Because the angels of Ar-Rahman, they have their wings over Asham, Syria and Palestine and Lebanon, those countries. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, الإيمان حين تكون فتنة في الشام. The real إيمان, you know the true believers when there's the fitna in Sham. Do we even make dua for our brothers? Or we take it as a joke? You take it as a joke. We should know something, ya ikhwan. Allah does not need me and you. Allah does not need us. You should know that. Don't forget that. Ya ayyuha an-nas, antum al-fuqara'u ila Allah. Allah says in his Quran, O people, you are the ones who are in need of Allah. And Allah is self-sufficient. He does not need us. If we do good, it is for our own selves. If we don't do good, if we can't help our brothers even by making dua, even by just remembering, فَسَوْفَ يَأْتِ اللَّهُ بِقَوْمٍ يُحِبُّهُمْ وَيُحِبُّونَ, then Allah will change us and bring other people who will really love Allah and Allah will love them. أَذِلَّةٍ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ أَعِزَّةٍ عَلَى الْكَافِرِينَ, those will be tough against the kuffar and those will be lenient to their fellow brothers. And it's not just Sham, all of you know how many people in different Islamic lands they're suffering. Do you even remember? At least do you make dua for them? But the nights and the days are going, and my death and your death is coming close. نسأل الله العظيم رب العرش الكريم أن يغفر لنا ذنوبنا ويكفر عنا سيئاتنا. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا المتقين إماما. ربنا هب لنا من لدنك رحمة وهيئ لنا من أمرنا رشدا. أقم الصلاة.